So this is a mandolin. It's basically a cross between a violin and a guitar. From the violin, it gets its tuning and its frequency range, and from the guitar, it gets its frets and its pick style technique. Here's a quick rundown of the anatomy of a mandolin. I'll be using some of these terms throughout. At the top is the headstock, where the strings are anchored in the tuners. There's the nut, the neck and the fretboard, the scroll, which is purely decorative, the body, with the top also being known as the soundboard, the F-holes, although some mandolins have oval holes similar to an acoustic guitar, the bridge, and the tailpiece where the end of the strings are held in place. If we zoom in, there's the frets. There are two main styles of mandolins. There's the teardrop-shaped A style and the more decorative F style. For all intents and purposes, the difference is aesthetic. F styles usually cost a little bit more than a comparable quality A style because the scrolls and decorative woodwork require more labor. I play an F style, FYI. To back up a bit and give an overview on how string instruments work in general, here's a highly simplified side view of an instrument. You can see the strings go from the tuners, through the nut, and over the bridge. A string instrument makes sounds via its vibrating strings, and the pitch or note that a string makes depends on how long the vibrating piece is. So if you press down the string here and pluck it near the bridge, the string will start to vibrate. The frequency of that vibration is the pitch you hear. If you press the string down closer to the bridge here, effectively shortening it, and pluck it, it'll vibrate at a higher frequency and thus a higher note. The sound of an acoustic instrument is not purely from the string, though. If we take a look at another simplified cross-section of a mandolin, you can see that, like most acoustic string instruments, a mandolin body is hollow. When the string vibrates, those vibrations are transmitted to the bridge, which transmits them to the soundboard, and the soundboard transmits them to the air inside the instrument. This amplifies the sound. A string by itself is so small that it would be barely audible, but the greater surface area of the now resonating soundboard wood vibrates more air and makes it louder, as well as giving the note other resonance frequencies that make an instrument have a characteristic sound. A B played on a mandolin has a different sound than a B played on a guitar. This is due to the physical configuration of its parts, the shape of the wood used, etc., etc. Also, some mandolins like mine have an electronic pickup built into the bridge. Pickups convert mechanical energy like that from a vibrating string into electrical signals. So when the string vibrates the bridge, in addition to transmitting the vibrations into the instrument body, it also converts them into signals and sends them to the output jack so you can electronically amplify the sound. Incidentally, this is why an instrument that is mic'd sounds different than it will through a pickup. Microphones convert the sound hitting them to electrical signals, including all the air vibrations caused by the resonating wood of the instrument. A pickup only converts the energy of the vibrating string to electric signals, so you don't usually get the same depth of sound. Comparing a mandolin with a violin, what they have in common are the string pitches and tuning. Both are tuned G, D, A, E, and the strings produce the same frequencies. Because of this, they use the same musical notation. If you can read violin music, you can play it on the mandolin, no translation required. The G, D, A, E tuning means the strings are tuned to fifths. In really general terms, it means that each string is five notes higher than the one below it. So D is five notes higher than G, A is five notes higher than D, etc., etc. The mandolin, while being tuned like a violin, differs in that it has doubled strings or courses, probably as a result of its lute ancestry. Making sure the strings are in tune with each other is extremely important, as having one of the pairs be even a little out can sound really bad. The most conspicuous difference between the two instruments is that you play a mandolin with a pick and the violin with a bow. A pick is also known as a plectrum. This means it has much less sustain than a violin. The note dies almost as soon as it sounds, rather than drawing out for as long as you can move the bow across it. The mandolin being a picked instrument makes playing it less complicated. Right-hand technique on a bowed string instrument is really important to getting a good sound, with bow pressure and placement being important, control coming from the elbow, wrist, and fingers. There's less factors in a pick, which is mostly just up and down with varying attack strengths. The other huge way mandolin is easier than violin is because of its frets. Having frets means that no matter where you press down behind a certain fret, the string is shortened by the same amount. You can think of it as being like a key on the piano. Put your finger anywhere behind a fret and you'll get the right note. The fret makes the contact point where the string vibrates from always the same so long as you're behind the fret. So pressing down on these two places will make the same note on a mandolin and not on the violin. In short, millimeters matter on a fretless violin. They don't on a fretted mandolin. Being slightly off in your finger placement on the violin can sound really awful. Hence, it's a hard instrument to be good at. Side note, the accuracy of your finger placement and therefore your pitch is called intonation. So if you look at the mandolin's other cousin, the guitar, we'll see there are more differences. Mandolins are tuned to fifths and guitars are tuned to fourths with one major third thrown in there. You can also see from the frequencies that the deepest string on a mandolin is equal to the fourth deepest on a guitar. Because of the tuning, the fretboard layout on a mandolin is easier to navigate than a guitar's. If we take a random major scale, A in this case, and chart out the notes on the fretboard, you can see that a mandolin scale is symmetrical and a guitar's isn't. Also, the mandolin being smaller, you can play more notes without shifting hand position since you can reach further. I can cover about 9 notes in first position on a mandolin and only about 5 on a guitar. I have longish, but not Rachmaninoff freak fingers. The frets are a lot smaller too on a mandolin, which takes some practice. String tension on a mandolin is much higher than a guitar, so it requires more hand strength and endurance than even an acoustic. The tension also means it's basically impossible to get a good sound out of it without using a pick. You can fingerstyle a guitar, but not a mandolin. I can't anyway. 7 billion people on Earth. Probably someone has done it. So that's a quick rundown on the anatomy of the mandolin. I hope it's been informative, and I really hope it's been interesting. Thanks for watching.